Hi, I'm Sally Erickson. I'm on the content publishing team at Microsoft, and I'd like to take a few moments to show you how you can contribute to the Microsoft Dynamics 365 documentation and make it better for everyone. You don't need to install any tools or software to contribute to our documentation. It can be done using your web browser. The first step is to sign up for a GitHub account. Please go to github.com and click Sign Up for GitHub. Follow the instructions that are displayed to create your account. Now that you have a GitHub account, you can contribute to the documentation. For example, you can add information or fix small errors or omissions in the documentation. Despite our best efforts, small grammar and spelling errors do make their way into the published documentation. While I can report mistakes like that, it's faster and easier to simply fix the issue. To contribute to the documentation on docs.microsoft.com, click the Edit button at the top of the page. The content then displays in GitHub in read-only mode. Now click the Edit button, which is the pencil icon. The content then displays in Edit mode. You'll notice a note at the top of your page that indicates that changes you make will be saved to a new branch in your fork. The words branch and fork are commonly used terms in GitHub. If you're not familiar with them, be sure to look at the GitHub documentation to become more aware of GitHub terminology and processes. The content of the file is displayed in Markdown. If you're not familiar with the Markdown language, there is plenty of information available on the web, including in the GitHub documentation. Now getting back to our task. You can go ahead and make your changes to the content. For example, in the Apply Updates to Cloud Environments content, I noticed that we didn't provide the acronym for the word Lifecycle Services. We commonly refer to Lifecycle Services as LCS. So after the first mention of Lifecycle Services, I'll enter the acronym LCS, just like that. When you're done making your changes, you can propose a file change. Enter a brief description about the changes you've made to the file. Then click Propose File Change. To submit the changes to Microsoft, you'll need to create a pull request. So go ahead and click Create Pull Request. Click Create Pull Request to submit the changes. If you are contributing to our documentation for the first time, you may be asked to complete a short Contribution License Agreement, CLA, depending on the magnitude of the proposed changes. After the CLA step is cleared, the pull request is processed. And that's all you need to do. Our content publishing team here at Microsoft will review the changes you've made. We'll gladly approve any changes you've made to fix small grammar or spelling errors. We may ask a member of the product team to review the accuracy of technical information you've added or changed. After we approve the changes, they'll be merged into the documentation and published. And there you go. In just a couple of minutes, we've shown you how you can contribute to the Dynamics 365 documentation and make it better for everyone. For more information, please see the Contributor's Guide on docs.microsoft.com. Thanks for watching!